Hey, Sushan, what's going on? A couple days ago, I was talking about my Michael, the Archangel character. I found this old file. How old is this file? Open. 2009. 2009. That's more than 10 years ago. That's right after I got Mongoose Trailer First Edition. I was thinking, I want to make an Eichler house, have my Michael the Archangel living in the house. So I made this little using Chief Architect. I made the floor plans and did the house thing. Here's the atrium. These houses all come with atriums. And I don't have any plans or nothing. It was just a rough draft thing. Back when I was thinking, oh, I'm gonna, because there was a time when I use constructs for my sets and stuff. Using the small G.I. Joes, which were perfect skill for constructs. And I thought, you know what? I have a computer now. I'll do CAD CAM design on my computer using everything except Google SketchUp, but I ended up using some Google SketchUp as well. Anyway, so there's different things. I like how the glass kind of reflects what's going on the other side of the atrium. But I don't do the computer much anymore, thanks to AI. Thanks to the AI now. In about, I don't know, a minute. In a minute, I get these photos from the AI. These are pseudo Eichler homes on a pseudo street in a pseudo neighborhood, and the pseudo cars look. They look about right. They look about the right style, color, the house colors, the grass, the sidewalks. This is how they used to make neighborhoods. And the houses are a bit small. They're a bit crunched together. I mean, these weren't tract houses, but I kind of want them to be tract housing. So no garages. The cars are in the driveway. If you're lucky, you have a carport. And it's kind of cool. So Michael the Archangel, he lives in one of these homes, right? This is the 1950s. And I even like in this one here. This one's more of a commune. Everyone shares the same front yard, kind of nonsense. This never happened. But there are houses that look like this. Modern homes, but they're not Eichler homes. They're just box homes. And I like that the AI had used some source footage that had rain, so the streets are wet. So that's kind of neat. And I like the style of plants used. So whatever Bing searches, the AI was searching for was finding homes that have, if not natural surrounding plants and shrubberies that don't need all that much water to rock gardens. Eichler homes were huge when it came to Japanese gardens, which were basically rock gardens, bonsai trees, that kind of thing. Things that didn't require much upkeep. You put those in your atrium. This is all outdoor stuff. But it's kind of interesting the AI chose the plants that it did. Because you want to show off the house, right? You don't want to cover the house up with, hedges and crap. But in reality, these homes would have glass on the back of the house and on the insides of the house, but not on the outside of the house. That's, privacy. You want privacy. When someone's walking down the street, you want privacy. This would just be cinder blocks here. Nothing to look at, nothing to see here. If anything, there'd be like one little slit one little vertical slit, usually near the front door somewhere, so people in the house could see someone coming up on the porch. You know, like here's a vertical slit right here. Perfect. That would be on the front of the house, not all. Anyway, you know what I mean. So I noticed the AI still has trouble making front doors. It doesn't know what the proportions of a human is yet. They'll fix it. They'll get that fixed. So pop inside, shall we? Oh, here's some more. These are more privacy looking things. These were the Eichler homes that had a fence surrounding the whole property except for the back of the house. So this is the front of the house and with the garden and all that stuff. You don't see this unless you get through the private entrance gate thing. I'm not sure how they got a car inside of theirs, but they did. The reflection of the car is different than the way the car is positioned. They need to fix that. Mirror reflections are hard as hell to do. Reflections, mirror surfaces, hard as hell to do. Physics engines, reality engines in these rendering things that 3D modeling apps use, they can't get it right. Because it's not a priority. For me, that's a big deal. It's kind of a big deal. You know, translucent metal. You know, how do you do that? How do you render translucent metal? That kind of thing. I do like they got the chair right. It's 1950s. The plants are right. They got the trip over tile right to the, you know, right to the door here. Technically, this is the front door right here. And, yeah, you can... No wheelchair access, as it should be. And, yeah, just concrete slabs put next to each other. Eh. Don't let fat people or trucks drive over it. As you know, inside we got atriums. Now, these are just simple prompts. I was just saying, for the first one, I think I just did a... Yeah, Eichler home with view of atrium, and then Eichler homes along a neighborhood street, and then, you know, I upscale this picture, one of these pictures, and then use that as I use a variant of this one to get these, you know, that kind of thing. So it's only like a few prompts I've used so far. This is about all. Overall, this was maybe, I don't know, 8 minutes. 8 minutes of me just dicking around with Midjourney. So inside, got an atrium. This looks rather lavish. You could have like a rock pond here if you want, or leave it dry. Either way, you got some things. You got open roof. Most of these atriums back in the day were just open roofs. But when it would rain, this would all flood. And when this would all flood, the rooms would flood. So people started putting plexiglass over the openings here. So it was more like a sun roof than an open roof. Plus, these are steel buildings with glass, and they're hard as hell to keep warm. during the winter, if it snows, you're in a shitload of hurt. So, some people, you know, perish the thought, but some people would actually convert the atrium into a room. And that would be the end of the atrium. That was the whole point of the homes, was you had an atrium in the center. And all the windows, all the rooms in the house had a window facing the atrium. Kind of cool. Here's a two-story Eichler home, which was never done. It was never a thing. I guess this could be considered a motel. There's no stairs in an Eichler home. But if there was, this is how it would look. Orange stairs. Either avocado or orange or pink or baby blue. You name it. Yeah, I just noticed that just now. Upper floor. Upstairs. Women's apparel and lingerie, you know, that kind of thing. Men's ties and shoes are downstairs. I like this atrium. See, this person, they closed off their roof completely, made it glass, glass roof, and turned the atrium into another room, and then opened up these. They're using curtains to replace, like, they take these glass windows out and put curtains there. So that's what they did on this house. So the AI was smart, found a modern home that's been restored by Architectural Digest, probably, a $15 million house. And it photocopied pretty much all the right elements from that article and made a house according to my specific prompt, which was Eichler home with atrium. There's no baby grand piano in here. There should be. But yeah, they removed the pond. There's usually a pond. Like, here's a pond. There's a dry one. Here's a pond. This one, the AI decided to put the plants on the inside in the kitchen area as well as on the outside. And then there's like another atrium over here. Like, actually, this could be the backyard of the house with plants. This is a jungle house, if you ask me. Kids running around playing Tarzan, crashing through windows, because the windows are so clean. Just run right through one. Tempered glass everywhere. Or non-tempered glass, as the case may be. Shards of glass. But I like the furniture. They pegged the furniture, even though it's 100% artificial. It looks the part. So I need to figure out how to do a bathroom facing atrium. So the glass wall in the bathroom with the tub facing the atrium. Michael the Archangel, home late as usual. It's like close to sunset outside, and he's throwing all of his weapons into the tub to give him a good rinsing. And maybe I upscaled this picture. It looks like there's some water left in this pond. It's hard to tell. And maybe this is the view from his bathroom, this area here. And so I thought I'd zoom out. I Midjourney has this trick where you can zoom out from a picture. And I was like, okay, is the AI smart enough to know that there's a glass, this is a glass window. Where I'm looking at here is like, it should be a glass window I'm looking through. So I zoom out, right? And I get this kind of a view. So here's the same, all of these pictures have the same atrium, but the AI just assumes the house just expands. The atrium just is, the atrium just goes. It just keeps going and going. It added on a whole extra. It's like a bunch of Eichler houses kind of fit together, like a donut shape almost. So we got the cool chairs. Got this futon bed, whatever these things are called. Got one of those. Here, there's not much extra furniture, but just more of that cool faux rock made of concrete. And then we got the here's a fake rock with a plate or something on it. These two look almost the same, except this is a green thing and this is an orange thing going on. I like how the AI, when I zoomed out, the AI just kind of filled in the rest of this room here, filled in the rest of this room here, filled this in. Looks like bookshelves or something over here. Filled this in with stuff. I mean, now that I've zoomed out, I would like to have a zoom in feature. I would like to zoom in and rotate 90 degrees to the right in this area and see what it shows me. Enhance, computer enhance. Anyway, so I'm not going to use the zoom because obviously the AI doesn't know. If you zoom out, I should be standing in the entrance of the house, maybe, or in the bathroom, one of the bedroom. I should be standing in one of the bedrooms or the bathroom if I'm standing here. The atrium just shouldn't expand out like that, but it did. So that was an interesting thing. So anyway, so what is this? This is episode two of my Michael Archangel thing. Now I need to fix Michael so he doesn't look like he did in the last video. He needs to look like one of the guys from Mad Men with the suit. Somehow he hides his wings under his t-shirt, which he has his jacket. His suit goes over that, so he can hide his ginormous wings that he has. Because at night he's out there fighting crime. And the neighbors wonder, what's all that racket going on at his house? So like if he lives in this house, this neighbor's probably complaining. 2 a.m. and he's sounds like he's got a chainsaw, doing some chainsaw. They have no clue what he does. They think he's a tax accountant or something. Anyway, so I've done this before, but it was World of Darkness I used in the game. We were using the World of Darkness, just World of Darkness. It was a unthemed, unsetting setting. It was just the generic book. It wasn't vampire werewolf. It was just anyway, I made up a Archangel character in the 50s. He's a of course immortal. What got me thinking about that was the movie Prophecy with Christopher Walken. And but put it in the 50s instead of whatever year that movie took place. Anyway, I'll let you guys go. Talk to you later.